Ashley Singh is live at the scene, and Ashley, crews are wrapping up their work right now.
Len, there's still a little more left to do. As you can see, there are crews out here. They're working, finishing up. They're cleaning up their equipment. I'm told that this has been an incredibly long day for them. This wet weather hasn't helped. The moisture actually reacted with the chemical, causing a dangerous gas to be released.
Apparently going around the ramp, it just slipped off of the vehicle, and some of the packages were broken.
Inside those packages were toxic material, magnesium phosphide, a type of pesticide. Police say the driver, who works for a pest control company, didn't realize they fell off his truck.
To his credit, he did turn right around and come back, and we probably would still be looking for who was responsible if he hadn't.
Three firefighters were injured during the cleanup. Officials say they felt nauseous and had difficulty breathing.
This is a toxic product. We don't know that it would build to a toxic level as it dissipates in the wind.
So as a precaution, officials evacuated many terrified residents on Eastwood Drive and Kent Street.
Wondering really how dangerous it is and how bad it is and how long we'll have to be away from home.
Kind of scary. I don't think, you know, something bad. I hope nothing bad happened.
Fire and emergency officials say they're familiar with this type of product. They, along with officials from several other city agencies, say the cleanup and evacuation couldn't have gone any smoother.
Everyone worked as a team, and that's what we're here to do.
I'm told the firefighters are all doing okay. Two of the three are actually back out here at the scene helping clean up. As for the truck driver, he's been charged with failure to secure a load. Live in Danville, Ashley Singh, ABC 13 News.
Good evening and thanks for joining us. A seven-month-old baby is dead after a shooting on Ramsey Road in Gretna yesterday morning. Police have arrested 21-year-old Nico Lamar King.
He is charged with second-degree murder and possession of a firearm as a convicted felon. Ashley Singh talked with some of the neighbors there, and Ashley, they are still really shaken up by this.
Right, Len, they're still in shock over what happened. I talked to the site manager over at the park today, and she tells me that she knew of domestic problems going on at the suspect's home, and she says she had warned him that it needed to stop.
He's gone. Taquan is gone, and we can't bring him back. We just have to pray for him, pray for the family.
Shirley Ward, the site manager at Park's Trailer Court, has known the suspect, Nico King, for many years. She says she's very disappointed in him.
I had a lot of faith and confidence in him. I really did.
After hearing several heated arguments coming from his trailer, Ward says she asked him to leave the park 3 weeks ago.
I let him know that the fighting and abusive and everything would have to go. I said, there's nothing good gonna come out of this. I said, you already on probation. I said, Nicole, you keep this up, you're going back to jail. I said, you need to get your clothes and you need to leave.
But he didn't move out. Donald Gregory, who lives next door to King, says he also heard the fights. What he didn't hear were the gunshots that went off early Sunday morning.
It's sad, you know, wake up and you see cops out here and wonder what they're out here for. And then you find out a 7-year-old baby been shot. Now, that's strange.
Like Ward, he too says it never should have happened.
Well, you can see it everywhere else, but never think it'll be right here beside you.
Ward feels sorry for the parents, but she says she knows their baby is in a better place.
He's already heaven bound. He already was an angel.
At this point, it's still unclear as to how King was related to the baby or his mother. Police are giving out very few details, saying that the shooting was domestic in nature. King is being held in jail under no bond. Noreen.
And Ashley, they're very, very worried that he may be hurt or worse.
Len, police say there are no signs of foul play, but they do think it's highly suspicious he hasn't been in contact with family or friends.
Carla Thomas says the night her son disappeared started off like any other. Corey told his mother he loved her and went to meet his friends. He never came home.
Sometimes I just wander off in my mind, and when I come back to reality, I realize he's not here. He's not here.
She says it kills her not to know what happened to Corey.
You don't know what it's like to be a mother and your child is out there somewhere and you don't know if they're cold or if they're hungry.
The family believes something or someone is preventing him from reaching out to them.
I would prefer that than to think that maybe he's thrown in a ditch or maybe they done buried him.
His aunt, Darlene Calloway, says they're trying to stay strong, but they worry Corey's suffering.
I would like to have my Corey back. We miss him. We love him. And if you took him, we love you too. Just send Corey back.
Carla says she's holding on to memories and to hope that her son is still alive.
I just want him to come home. Come home.
Police say they've received reports of a tan or gold Corolla that was last seen with Corey's van. They want to hear from whoever was inside that car. If you have any information, call the sheriff's office at 276-656-4200. Len. The two were in ROTC together, and I'm told that since graduation, they continued to hang out. Friends say two bright futures have been lost.
He doesn't hang around a lot of trouble, and to see something this bad happened to him, it just strikes me to my core.
Friends say Alex Hernandez was a great kid who had no enemies. They say even the suspect, Tommy Green, was supposed to be his friend.
I don't see how he could have done this, Alex. I really don't. You know, this is way out of the blue.
Those friends, you know, they never fought, they never talked bad to each other. I mean, you had your disagreements, you know, with command of ROTC, but they talked about it, you know, like adults. And I just can't believe it happened.
Will Hodges, a former classmate of Hernandez and Green, says both were smart kids. Hodges says to see Green charged with murder is surprising because he wanted like his father, a Roanoke County police officer.
I thought he wanted to go to the FBI to study like Arabic and be a translator. I thought he had a bright future, you know, just both of them did, but I guess not anymore.
Sheriff Ewell Hunt says Green was the last person seen with Hernandez. He says Green initially told investigators the two met inside Walmart the afternoon Hernandez went missing. Hunt says they had no reason not to believe him until they looked at surveillance video.
Things just didn't match up as inconsistencies in Mr. Green's information.
After days of searching, investigators say the suspect finally told them where he had hidden the body, in these woods next to that mobile home. His friends say despite all the questions surrounding his death, the only thing they know for certain is that Hernandez was taken too soon.
We're all thinking about him. He's on our mind. He'll be with us forever.
Tommy Green has been charged with first-degree murder and use of a firearm while in commission of a felony. He's being held without bond. Live in Danville, Ashley Singh, ABC 13 News.
Ashley Singh is live in Danville. Ashley, the numbers come from a AAA study. Of course, New Year's celebrations often bring out drunk drivers and lead to deadly wrecks.
Right, Len, it's no surprise to state police. They tell me that in Pennsylvania County alone this year, there have been 13 fatal wrecks, and half of them have been alcohol-related. According to AAA, 1 out of 10 people admit that they may have driven drunk in the past year. It's a sobering statistic, but one some say isn't hard to believe.
Is that something you've ever done?
Oh, yes. Yes, I've done it.
Curtis Mendenhall says he tries not to drink and drive, but admits that sometimes he does.
Well, I think it's true. I mean, some of us stop at bars and have a drink, and then we go home.
According to the study, most drivers disapprove. 87% believe drinking and driving is a very serious threat.
I think if you're on the road, you need to be sober. No drinking allowed.
First Sergeant David Cooper says people who drink and drive think they're invincible. He says he knows that's not true.
Driving drunk will kill not only yourself, but other innocent people involved driving down the road.
Actually, my grandmother's brother was killed by a drunk driver years ago. There's consequences to your actions. And that's, you know, everybody really needs to remember that when they go out and do something.
For those who just don't want to take a risk on the roads, they say they'll stay at home.
I know that a lot of people are out there. They've been to parties. They've been drinking. So we just prefer to stay home.
It's safe. We're safe at home.
If you are going to be on the road and you think that someone near you is driving drunk, get as far away from them as possible. Call police, give them a vehicle description and a tag number. Len.